Welcome to another edition of Politics Done Right. I'm Egberto Willis, your host. I'm here with the one and only Jose Williams. Jose Williams and I go back from the CNN iReport days of over 10 years ago when CNN was really invested into bringing iReporters from all over the country to really report what was going on in their communities. A lot of that has changed since, but welcome aboard, Jose Williams. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good, E. It is very good to be with you. I'm sorry we couldn't connect yesterday, but it was just one of those days filled with excitement and all kind of overwhelmingness. So there was a lot going on yesterday, but I'm glad to be able to speak to you and your viewers today. You know I catch your show. You know, even though I don't respond a lot, I like to sit there in the truck and see what's up with E. He's on track. He's talking about the issues, and maybe one day we'll get together. You know, it would have been great for yesterday. But here we are now.
Well, you know, we've gotten together at these functions so many times. We were together at the DNC. You came, you drove through here to Houston, and I made sure to come and find you where you were here in Houston. So, you know, we go back a long time. Let me first tell the folks, what were you doing yesterday? What was what event did you attend yesterday?
Yesterday, we attended the 57th anniversary of the the March on Washington, where Martin Luther King spoke of his hopes and dreams for this country and the future of black people within this country. That was held and put together by Al Sharpton and his organization, the National Action Network. And I got to give it to him. Dude, there were seas of people there, seas. And for all those people, they had umbrellas, they had water, they had masks, they had, everything was so coordinated where, you know, you would have been concerned, is this going to be, you know, handled in a very specific way so all these people would be accommodated? No problems. So a big up to our friend Al Sharpton and the National Action Network, because they did a fantastic job organizing and following through with that with the March on Washington.
It is amazing that just the day before, there was the march on the White House where 1,500 to 2,000 people were sitting on the lawn, all without masks, presenting themselves or creating what's likely to be a mass spreading event around the country. We bring several tens of thousands of people to the mall, and they were all doing what was right. And you told me yesterday that it was like, it looked like America, the people out there. Tell us a little bit about that.
I tell you, E, you know, my brother, Ricardo Williams, who came as the Patriot, you may have seen his picture. He's in who knows how many publications now on the internet. And my wife, Lucy, there were all kinds of people there. We saw so many different organizations, from the ACLU to the Arab organizations, to Asian organizations, Rainbow, Black, Green. You could have had some Martians inside there, you know, for all I know. There were so many people, and we were all in solidarity for the issues of equality for all for this country and to stop all the racist brutality that these police, these white police, not all of them, but, you know, the few get noticed on these harsh issues of these deaths that did not have to be, of these poor black men doing what they normally do in this country that they love, yet are cut down in the middle of their life, leaving families to grieve for nothing. But everybody was there in solidarity. The power of that strength, man, of camaraderie and people being collective in the idea, and everybody there of like minds, wanting not only Trump out, but wanting to delve down into this issue to stop this police injustice against people of color. And it's structural setup as it is structurally in all our laws, you know, local and national laws. We were all there. And I tell you, again, the March on Washington back 57 years ago had nothing on the amount of people that were there yesterday. And it was still conducted very coordinated. There were a lot of speakers there. I can't even, you know, I'm so kind of still overwhelmed, you know, trying to still digest it all. But there were so many speakers there Martin Luther King Jr., his daughter. Of course, Al Sharpton gave a very good speech and was very, he was tactful, but critical. You know what I mean? He got his point across as who we need to look to for leadership and who we need to get rid of.
Jose, earlier we were talking about this before we kind of got cut off earlier, and this, you made an important statement about who Americans are. All of us are Americans now. All of us were Americans from the inception of this country. And in fact, I think you made this clear with your statement, in as much as many times some Americans want to erase Black Americans as somehow being foundational to this country, it's dispelled by the reality that the first person who died for the creation of America as a state was Crispus Attucks, which was a Black man. Isn't that true?
That is true, and that is the history, although, you know, you might not get taught that in fifth grade and through high, you know, through all your years in school. And that's something, sorry for my finger, and that's something that my brother, Ricardo Williams, he wanted to make a statement, and he came dressed in colonial wear, and all the reporters are asking him, is like, so, you know, what does this mean? And as he said to everybody, this is, I'm wearing this garb, this costume, because he wanted to remind all Americans, especially white Americans and white Americans in power in politics, that Black people have been in this country before it was a country. We've loved it. We helped make it a country. We've loved it ever since, fought in every war and every social uprising to make good change. Yet we are denied the rights that is given to all Americans, and it's not right, and people need to understand that history so they can, you know, maybe think back, you know, people of goodwill can think and say, hey, you know, like they are now with all these protests, you know, they're like, wait a minute, my brother is the Black guy, is the Asian man, is, you know, we're all one. The American Indian is the only true American, you know, because, you know, we came here. Exactly. You know, we were brought here, you know, unwillingly. But once we got here, we have fought and died and tried to cultivate this country like any American that loves the land that he stands on.
You know, there's a basketball player. I don't remember the name. He became a coach, and he came out and said, you know, it's almost like I'm loving America. America does not love me back. That, I've heard that in so many different forms from so many different people. And my thing has always been, let's not wait for America to love us back, because we are America.
Very good. That's true.
I wanted to reply. I wish I was there in real time, because I want a lot of times for us to stop saying we're waiting for America to love us or for America to treat us well. Because I want what more of us to do is to start saying we are America. If America is not treating us well, then we are not treating us well, which means we must do what we are doing now to force our body to treat our totality well. And that's where I want us to come from. And what I've been noticing, this is so very important. A lot of people, white people and everybody else, they are starting to see the morality in that reality. And if you take a look, you've mentioned about how that protest looked yesterday on the mall, that march on the mall yesterday. And if you the two people that were gunned down by that terrorist in the two people that were gunned down by that terrorist
in Wisconsin Russia
were two white guys in the
right.
So those are the things that we're starting to see, as you expressed.
Well, that's the thing. That's the injustice that's so in your face. The young man that killed the two people in Wisconsin protesting peacefully, as is every American's right, was from Illinois. Yet that man shot people, walked up to the police that were just hanging around, and somehow, like, just took a bus home? And then they capture him in Illinois. So what were those police doing there? Now, you know, and anyone of goodwill that wants to be clear and honest If that had been a black man just walking down the street with an M16, slung to his shoulder, he would have been shot dead. You know, hell, black people have been shot for, as we've seen recently, for killed for less than that.
For having no weapon.
Right. With no weapon. Just, you know, jogging as the guy in Atlanta, in Brunswick, Georgia, or George Floyd. You know, it wasn't – he didn't do anything wrong. There was nothing proven. A guy thought that he might have been – he might have been passing a 20. How many 20s – I've done that myself. Give a guy a 20, get him from the cash checking place or wherever, and, oh, this looks fake. Oh, you know, well, I just got that. And they simply exchange it. This man had to die and call for his mother with his dying breath. That is wrong. And the Republicans and Trump and those of that ilk – have nothing to say? You know what? One thing, let me be clear. One thing that was said continually over in this, at this march, especially from our youth that is now, you know, in college and studying these issues and going into politics, they demand. It's no more time for asking. Why are we asking for something like you so clearly espouse? We are Americans. We deserve our franchise. We are not asking anymore. We've asked for 57 years ago, Martin Luther King asked, you know, and all our dignitaries up till this point have asked. No more asking. We demand that they recognize our right to be Americans because we are Americans.
And, you know, that is the one thing that you're so right about that. And that is the one thing that I thought was always missing in the previous types of rallies, in the previous types of where we're trying to demand or get our rights. We have made it the purview of others to give
right.
something that is already ours.
Right.
We have just not. It is just like having stock options not exercised.
Right.
Right. So my thing is, we should have exercised our stock options. Our stock options is Americanism. We as Americans, those stock options should have been exercised long time ago. And now is the time that we will exercise it and not allow a president to demagogue it, a president
yes.
to use it to scare white people into
their right.
Get you. Because I tell you what, if as a culture, black folks really wanted retribution, America would have been a very bloody place. But by nature, by who they are as a culture, and notice
yes.
I'm talking culture. I'm not talking race, because there's nothing called race. Is a thing that's used that's obvious to people, so they can degrade or gradate people. I'm talking
yeah.
as a culture. As a culture, that mean-spiritedness of retribution is not a large portion of it.
Right.
Right?
I agree.
That is why now more than ever, that change should be made. Because I tell you what, that power of love, that power of we are not looking for retribution is not forever.
Right. I agree.
Even a spring breaks at a particular stress level.
And you know what's interesting? Like I say to my children, you know, I'll say, hey, you know what? My son and my sons and my daughters, like, look, I did what I had to do. I'm going to be 61. I busted my hump to get Obama inside there. One, because he was a good, honest man first. And he's a black man. Yeah, I'm going for this. We're going to go with it. We did what we had to do. And generations before me that allowed me to do what I was doing, run around, you know, E, run around the country with a picture of a black man to be president. I'm lucky I'm still walking.
And you're in some crazy towns, brother.
Yes, you know that because you're in Texas and those towns are there. And, you know, I understood what I was about to do could get difficult. You know, like I bought a black flags, a black Lives Matter flag to put on my truck. And when I go out this trip on Tuesday, I know, as I told my wife, you know, there could be some issues. But as generations before us did what they had to do. John Lewis, as the big example, was discussed a lot yesterday. We did our thing. Now it is up to the young people, and I was so gratified, so hopeful to see them on that stage. And again, not asking, demanding. Because look at it. If you're a young kid, you go to high school, you're going to school, you got all kind of kids next to you. When I went to school here in Westchester County, in Mayapack, New York, I was of three of us, three people of color in the school. So it was kind of difficult, but I got a good education and I made it through. But kids these days, they got all kind of different races, cultures, you know, sitting at the Asian, the Arab, everybody's inside there. They look at the TV and they see everybody as an example of our population of America on the TV. So when they see, you know, people of color get shot down, it's like, wait a minute.
That's my friend.
This ain't right. You know, something screwy, which is why you see all these young people involved in this. And I love it.
I'm going to close on that positive statement of yours.
Thanks.
Jose Williams, former CNN iReporter, business owner of a trucking company, somebody who should scare Donald Trump because he believes in free enterprise.
Yeah.
He believes in democracy, something that is completely anathema to the president, the current president of the United States. Jose Williams, thank you so kindly for having been on Politics Done Right.
Thank you, E. I appreciate you having me. And one last thing, you make sure you let your vote, your viewers, they must vote. Vote. Freedom is not free. Vote. Then you'll be free. Thank you, my brother.
Jose Williams, be well.
Be well. Bye-bye.
I'm Egberto Willis, host of Politics Done Right, an independent news program. I post several news videos of interest every day. I ask you so kindly to subscribe to my channel, and please leave me some comments. Thank you very much.